So congratulations on an impressive victory. I can't imagine there'd be much to criticize, but how do you evaluate your performance this evening?
It was a good performance. I think it's my fourth first round knockout in the UFC now. I just came in to work off the jab, and the jab actually got the job done tonight, so yeah.
Very nice. He was kind of a wild card. I mean, was that like a game plan specific for him, or is that just kind of, you know, we've seen your boxing obviously continues to get better and better, so was that anything for him specifically, or just kind of your game at this point?
Yeah, that's my game, you know. Like I say, he's a bit of a wild card, and he's a switch hitter. I think he switched a bit in the fight. Worked my hands, and, you know, I think you can see that I've worked a lot on my athleticism as well. I'm a lot bigger and stronger at this weight. My last two fights, I got in here at 187. You know, it's not good enough now. You know, I'm like big 200 pounder, and you know, I'm taking things serious.
Yeah, I know you didn't win last time out, but some consistency, right? I mean, it's been tough for you over the years to get consistent time in the cage. How important do you think that is to your performance to be able to get in there and stay in there?
It's big, you know. Every fight you have, you learn, and you need that fresh memory of being in there. I mean, my last fight, I had one fight in 4 years going into it, and that was a first round finish. So, you know, hopefully now I can start gaining some momentum.
Yeah. And you've been open about the challenges that you've had, you know, mentally. Do you feel like you've turned a corner on that? And if so, what is it? What made the difference?
You know, when we face challenges, you have to, you know, go look deep inside. And for me, I didn't want to just, you know, hide away at home and settle for an average life. You know, I put too much time into this game, and you know, I want to be great. You know, I want to be a great fighter, and you know, that's my mission.
Was it tough to talk about those things? I mean, I think when I think of you, I don't think of a guy that talks a whole lot, and yeah. You know, this is kind of a macho sport and all that. I mean, was it difficult to be open and honest?
In the past, it would have been, but now I don't care about the opinion of others. You know, I'm in this for myself, and you know, I'm open. I'll say whatever's on my mind now. You know, that's it. That's it. Yeah.
Nice. Last thing for me. I mean, great performance. What do you want to do from here? I mean, do you want some time off? Do you want to try to get another one in before the end of the year? Is there a name, a date? What makes sense for you now?
I heard that they're coming back here in January, so that would be perfect, really. You know, get back and keep building, and January would be perfect.
All right. That jab you dropped him with, were you surprised that he fell after connecting?
I hurt him with a few jabs. Like, there was a jab before that I saw his eyes roll back a little bit, and there was like a moment in the fight where he threw a few kicks at me, and I didn't really feel phased with his power, so I thought, okay, and now I'll just put him on the back foot and start landing my shots.
So in the middle of the fight, you quickly realized he had nothing for you?
Yeah, pretty much.
And then you mentioned you didn't really care about the opinions of others when it comes to mental health and stuff. But do you want to use your platform to kind of promote mental health awareness in these athletes? Because technically today is World Mental Health Day. I don't know if you were aware of that.
I mean, if I can help people, that's great. You know, it's very rewarding to help others. But I'm not in it for like a big ego thing or anything like that. You know, I'm in it for genuine reasons.